Hello, Kenneth Steinis here with Sensei. Microsoft is doubling down on the consolidation of tools and the focus on providing a platform for work, project, and portfolio management. The new Microsoft Planner combines To-Do, Microsoft Planner, and Microsoft Project for the web into a single app for task and work management. That, in and of itself, is extremely valuable when it comes to managing work. Then, when used in combination with Microsoft Teams for collaboration and the Power Platform for more advanced PPM scenarios and reporting, it's a very powerful platform for work, project, and portfolio management. As a Microsoft client, you're leveraging the investment you've already made and keeping your data and user authentication safe and secure inside your own Microsoft 365 tenant. The new Planner has launched as an app in Microsoft Teams and will also be available as a web experience later this year. To access the app, click the ellipse on the left-hand side in Microsoft Teams and type Planner if it isn't showing up already. You can then pin it so that it's always available in the menu on the left. The first thing you see in Planner is the My Day view. It shows you what you should be focused on right now across private tasks, flagged emails, basic and premium plans. So how do tasks get here? Well, you can add and remove them manually from here. And tasks will also show up in this view automatically if their due date is today. You can status your tasks directly in the grid, or you can open a task to see more details and status the work here. And of course, you can create a new private task here too. The My Tasks view shows all work regardless of when it's due. I tend to sort by due date though, so I can see if anything's falling behind. Across the top, you can filter for private tasks. Those are the ones you've created and no one else can see these. Then there's Assigned to Me, which is work from basic and premium plans that's been assigned to you, as the name suggests. I'll get back to the difference between basic and premium plans in just a minute. The last filter at the top is for flagged emails, which is a really cool addition if, like me, you use flags in your emails to tag items for follow-up. When I open a task here, the email shows up in the attachment section. I love this. When you're looking through your tasks, you can filter based on due date, priority, and progress. And Microsoft has placed the search in the top left corner, both in this view and inside of an individual plan. I can search for approvals, for example, and see all related tasks. So far, we've focused on tasks in two separate views. The next view is the My Plans view, where we can see all the plans we have access to. You'll notice in the grid that it shows me the privacy level, whether it's shared or only you who has access. If it's shared, the last column shows which Microsoft 365 group it's shared with. Again, we have the filters across the top for recent, shared, personal, pinned, and My Teams. I've mentioned basic and premium plans a few times already, so let's talk about the differences. In a nutshell, a basic plan is what you're used to from the old planner in Microsoft 365. These plans are quite good for simple task management, for ongoing work, or perhaps very small projects. You get a rich task experience where you can see who the task is assigned to, any labels, you have buckets, progress, priority, start date, due date, options to repeat a task, notes, checklists, attachments, and team members can add comments on a task as well. And all tasks from basic plans feed into the task views we looked at earlier. If you need more than that, you can step up to a premium plan, which gets you more advanced options. With a premium plan, you can build a traditional work breakdown structure. You get milestones, task effort, duration, percent complete, dependencies, custom fields, task history, conversations, assignments, baseline, Copilot, timeline view, sprint functionality, team workload, roadmap, project goals, custom calendars, reporting and extensibility through the Power Platform. So you can think of a premium plan as being Microsoft Project for the Web on steroids. And while the core functionality of Project for the Web, or now premium plans, hasn't changed too much, the integration into the Planner app comes with some very important additional benefits. Most importantly, an improved team member experience where they can now see tasks across projects in those two views we looked at earlier. This was a big gap that's now been filled. Another benefit, of course, is Copilot for AI integration. We'll look at that in a minute. First, let's take a look at a premium plan in the new Planner. As I mentioned earlier, Microsoft moved the search to the top left corner, so it's now easy to find specific tasks in the plan. At the task level, premium plans offer a more detailed and rich experience with duration, percent complete, sprint functionality, effort, custom fields, advanced dependencies with lead and lag time, as well as task conversations and teams, and the ability to connect tasks to project goals. You even get a complete task history so you can track detailed changes on the task. The upgraded board view helps you organize the work into customizable buckets. I've grouped the work by functional area in this plan. And you can also choose to see the work by who it's assigned to, or by progress to show tasks not started, in progress, and completed. Grouping by finish date calls out any tasks that are late, due today, next week, or at a future date beyond that. And you can group by labels, which shows the phases of the project in this example. There's a priority field for each task, so this board makes it easy to see what the most urgent and most important work is. If your development team wants to manage their work in sprints, they can easily filter the sprint board for their tasks, and it doesn't change the end date or the dependencies of the tasks when you move items from the backlog into specific sprints. With the interactive timeline view, you can visualize the work, then drag tasks to shift the dates, extend the duration of a task, create dependencies between tasks, and show the critical path of the project. The charts view summarizes tasks by status, bucket, and effort per person. The people view helps us better understand and balance workload, either by number of tasks or hours assigned. If you turn off compact mode, you'll get the full richness of the tasks and stay in context of those color-coded buckets. With goals, you can begin with the end in mind and connect the tasks that'll get you there. For an even more granular view, see the assignments by resource or by task at a daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly level. Then, of course, there's Copilot for artificial intelligence. With simple natural language prompts, Copilot and Planner will help you with a number of different things, and not only from data inside the plan. If I ask about my next status meeting, Copilot will check my calendar and show the next appointment related to this project. You can even ask Copilot to help you with goal setting so everyone knows what you're working towards. I'll show another example of Copilot when we create a new schedule in a little bit. One of the most recent additions is baselining in premium plans. We can now capture a baseline for the project and all the tasks within it. For a more detailed rundown of this feature, you can see a link in the description below. The filters are great for larger schedules when you're trying to find a subset of tasks quickly. You can filter the views for sprints, finish date, progress, labels, buckets, priority, critical path, goals, and who the work is assigned to, and also certain custom fields you may have created, like the value field I'm showing here. I personally find coloring very helpful, so the option to do conditional coloring in the grid view helps quickly make sense of the data. All right, that's a super quick walkthrough of what's inside of a premium plan. Let's bring it up a level again and look at how you create a new plan and use templates. When creating a new plan, you get a choice between a blank basic or a blank premium plan. unless you want to start from a template, and these also come in basic and premium versions. The built-in templates are fine, but we really need Microsoft to allow us to upload custom enterprise templates. That will be extremely helpful. In the meantime, you can create a plan with the word template in the name and then copy it from the dropdown next to the name. For now, we'll create a blank premium plan for the Madison Avenue sidewalk expansion. We'll pin it for easy access, but let's not share it just yet. Again, Copilot can help save you time by creating relevant tasks quickly. Simply tell Copilot what you would like to accomplish, and it will add a set of tasks to your plan. The level of detail and quality will only get better over time, but this is a good start. So, right now, this plan is a private plan and available only to you. If you want to share it with others, you'll need to either create a new Microsoft 365 group and add members to it, or add the plan to an existing group which already has team members. This is not just about sharing the plan with others, though. Adding a Microsoft 365 group also puts in place the infrastructure you need behind the scenes, including a SharePoint team site with a document library to store your files. You get the ability to create a channel in Microsoft Teams for the project with a shared email address and a project calendar, as you'll see in a minute. The core work management capabilities for Microsoft have really come a long way and are very competitive, as you've just seen in the new planner. When used in combination with Microsoft Teams, each project then gets a dedicated channel for collaboration. Let's take a quick look at that. A team typically represents a group of people already working together. This could be a department, a program, or portfolio, for example. Then, within that team, each channel represents a project. That means you get an email address and a calendar for the project. The ability to follow any activity on the project from the post tab, access the files that are stored in SharePoint, and capture notes in OneNote. And that's in addition to the tasks from the plan, of course. Since premium plans come from what was previously Microsoft Project for the Web, you have the entire Power Platform available to you for extensions and reporting. That means you can add features and capabilities on top of the tasks in the plan. This is what really completes the platform for work project and portfolio management. At Sensei, we've built a best practices template on the Power Platform with the most common extensions and reporting packs. For project management, that includes governance workflows for projects with built-in approvals, key dates, project financials, deliverables, status updates, issues and risks, decisions, change requests, and lessons learned, as well as automated reporting for the individual project and aggregated to show a view of all work in the organization. Project managers even get their own app that shows all activity and people on the projects they're responsible for. For program and portfolio management, there is a standard intake process with business case, timelines, resource demand, scoring, prioritization, and resource forecast, all to help organizations select the right projects. There's the ability to issue challenges and capture ideas for ongoing innovation, and, of course, the ability to formally manage programs and portfolios with reporting that visualize it all. For resource management, you can see availability across your teams, formally request and allocate resources to projects, and team members can track their time for cross-charging or to capitalize labor expenses. Reporting pulls it all together for visibility into bottlenecks and exceptions. For strategy, you can define your organization's strategic themes and then track which projects help to move the needle and measure progress through strategic goals. You may also choose to track benefits realization well beyond the completion of the project. Microsoft's new approach is not only feature-rich and very capable, but in leading with the platform, all of the apps you use live inside your existing Microsoft 365 tenant. That's important because it means users are authenticated there and all the data lives there too. You're no longer dealing with third-party cloud providers where your data lives in somebody else's cloud. For additional information about the roadmap for Microsoft Planner, licensing, and how you can get the Sensei IQ template for your organization, see the links in the description below. And if you found this video valuable, please be sure to subscribe to this channel. We have lots more great content coming out soon. And do check out our website at senseiq.com, of course. Thanks.